This video will explain more about diffusion tubes and how to use them. Diffusion tubes are widely used for measuring ambient concentrations of nitrogen dioxide. Nitrogen dioxide is a gas that is mainly produced during the combustion of fossil fuels. Short-term exposure to concentrations of nitrogen dioxide can cause inflammation of the airways and increased susceptibility to respiratory infections and to allergens. Nitrogen dioxide can exacerbate the symptoms of those already suffering from lung or heart conditions, as well as cause changes to the environment through things like soil chemistry and affect the biodiversity in sensitive habitats. Now, diffusion tubes are described as passive samplers, and they consist of small plastic tubes containing a chemical reagent to absorb the pollutant to be measured directly from the air. And in the case of these nitrogen dioxide diffusion tubes, the absorbent used is triethanol amine, or it's often shortened to TEA or T. Now, in it, there is a stainless steel mesh grid at the closed end of the tube, which is coated with a water-based or acetone-based solution of this absorbent. You might just be able to see it in the end of this cap that I've pulled off. Now, the end caps that hold the grid is made of an opaque, flexible plastic of a dark colour. In this case, it's grey, but it is often red. And this is to stop the sunlight degrading the nitrate complex formed when the nitrogen dioxide combines with the T. These sorts of diffusion tubes can be used to measure roadside pollution. And when they're used in this circumstance, they should be sighted between 1 and 5 metres from the curb edge and mounted ideally either on a lamppost or road sign on the pavement. They can also be used to monitor the urban background ambient pollution, and they must be sighted more than 30 metres from a busy road. They can also be used to monitor indoor air quality, but when mounted indoors, they should be mounted away from air conditioning or vents which create turbulent flow and can affect the concentration within the tube. When setting these up, the diffusion tube must be held vertically and we open the end downwards that's being sampled. It is the white cap that you remove, and the coloured cap is at the top and stays on. Normally a permanent clip is also used to mount the tubes for ease of use and to keep the tube away from materials which might absorb nitrogen dioxide and affect the results. And the tube might be mounted with double-sided tape or with a cable tie. It's important that the open end of the tube is exposed to free circulation of air, not covered by vegetation or other materials. And ideally it would be mounted between 1.5 and 2 meters high. It's best to monitor the air quality at the height it's breathed, but often this is not possible because of the risk of damage or vandalism to the tubes. So you want them not directly in sight of people. It's important to record the date and time of the start of the exposure period on the form, and to keep the end caps in the bag or container for use when the exposure period is completed. We recommend that you leave the tubes in place for 3 weeks, which is about 504 minutes. The tubes should be capped securely after use. And it's important to log the location and exposure time for the diffusion tubes, which are then sent off to a lab for testing. For reference, the Air Quality Standards Regulations of 2010 require that the annual mean concentration of nitrogen dioxide must not exceed 40 micrograms per cubic meter. Also, it might be of interest that the average indoor reading is normally around 9 micrograms per cubic meter. The results show the average over the period the tubes have been up. It might be suitable to swap the tubes and monitor a location continuously for a year to explore seasonal variation. It's also worth noting that due to the average nature of the tubes, it's not possible to monitor daily peaks with these sorts of diffusion tubes. And for much of the night, the reality is that a roadside might actually experience very little traffic. So there are other devices that do real-time monitoring in order to explore daily peaks and troughs. The tubes monitor the air a person would breathe as if they were standing there static for a three-week continuous period, day and night. Thank you for watching, and I hope this was useful. Bye.